For me, this is crucially important how we deal with history, because I think that if we will deny the past, then the lack of this memory and the lack of responsibility, the feeling of co-responsibility, responsibility, or even the knowledge on the facts, historical facts, will never allow to build a different society and different attitudes. I'm really afraid of Polish students at schools, what kind of history teaching they will be getting now about their own past, because living and thinking that actually your grandparents, great-grandparents were only heroes and saviors of others and never perpetrators of crimes against the others is a very wrong and bad basis for the future.
The number of anti-Semitic events is actually how you define anti-Semitism. So Mr. Zissels actually insists that hate crime is anti-Semitism, hate speech is not, which means that they can, in the democratic country, to say whatever they want, unless they do not beat Jews physically. Israeli institutions insist that it starts with the hate speech and is going to finish with the hate crime. So we should include everything inside. Xenophobe is quite often anti-Semitic and vice versa, so we could estimate the level of anti-Semitic impressions among the Ukrainian public. For me, it seems to be not enough. So what I did, I asked my colleagues to make like a pilot study. We see that attitude to Jews is a little bit improving in the course of the time. In principle, about 10% insist that they see Jews with a sympathy, and another more than 80%, like normal people, no, nothing special. It depends on the human being, it depends on the person, and there is no need to define specially reference to Jews. If they are good, they are good. If they are bad, they are bad. Forget about it.
In conclusion, radical anti-Zionism should be seen as the policy of the SS. Evil. For the Belgian of the third millennium, anti-Zionism is a matter of consensus and sense. Opposition to Israel serves the interest of all the components of contemporary Belgian society. Recently, one of the most influential Flemish columnists compared the Flemish to the Palestinian and, of course, the Francophone to the Israeli. For them, the real Palestinians are the Francophone, the Flemish playing in their editorial the role of the cruel Israeli. No other conflict commands such attention in Belgian university. BDS groups are more and more active with Belgian campuses. One should then consider anti-Zionism as a veritable cultural code that acts as a fantastic evidence which serves to express all sorts of purposes. The criticism of Israel or Armenia to attract Turkish votes has become the best way to please the Muslim voters.
The Palestinian-Israeli conflict, in the mind of many, cannot constitute anymore the master key solution for the Middle East. It is a problem. It should deal with that. But it has nothing to do with solving out the problems of the Middle East. Palestinian-Israeli conflict is solvable. Sunnah and Shia is not solvable. We have to make sure that our next generations are not going to be affected by the pies in the sky, because that was put to the test and was really, really dangerous for Israel. It created a lot of animosities from within, dichotomies, and of course, it brought the history back to the front.
Syrians from Aleppo, from the slums of Aleppo, they were originally from a small farming village that went to Aleppo. Their homes are completely bombed. They have no place to return to. Let me just show you, it's a clip of the projects that we did and completed.
We are living in a very difficult time where we face severe anti-Semitism. Anti-Semitism today is sophisticated. It appears itself in so many different areas and ways. It hides itself in the BDS movement and the delegitimization of the State of Israel. It appears at the United Nations, where Israel is subjected to incredible under severe attack. Of course, one of the places it is most found on social media and on the university campuses. Anti-Semitism is a threat to the State of Israel and the Jewish people. It might start with Israel, but then goes on to affect the entire world. I hope that together the State of Israel and the European Union can continue to fight anti-Semitism. I am sure that together we will prevail and the State of Israel will continue to be the light unto all the nations.